Hi, my name is Lijo Jose Pellissery. I am here to talk about the climax of my film Angamaly Diaries. It's 11 minute long single take.
Do naina, do naina parinde bhar gaye udaan.
When you start the scene, you can see that there's a fireworks trolley which is there, which is normally the clubs there in Angamaly, they organize this fireworks during church festivals. So it's a firework thing which is about to start. That's what you are seeing. So it's basically getting the audience to the scene. Basically, you don't feel like you're watching a cinema. That was the idea behind this long take. So what we did was initially it was like in the daytime we went with our actors, the DOP, and our basic core team. So the street was like empty in the morning. So we just structured the entire choreography of the sequence. So where to stop, where to move, what should happen where should the fight happen. All this we started improvising with only these actors. So basically it was not even a rehearsal with the crowd. So we didn't know how it will be when the crowd come in the evening. So we just practiced it like that, the camera movement with a normal phone, we practiced it. When in the evening, when the crowd came in, so the real fear, the real hang of the entire thing we got. It wasn't that easy as it looked in the afternoon, like a empty street. The best thing happened in the shoot was movie 10. Movie 10 is an alternative for Steadicam. Steadicams we used to use to get a moving shot in a steady form. But now we have a much more easier equipment to handle. Movie 15 is much more compact in terms of handling. So it's since it was a very long take, like 11 minutes. So the cam weighs around like more than 2 kgs, and this equipment again. So it's basically around proper 4 to 5 kgs of weight, which the cameraman will be handling. So the initial 10 minutes, it was like normally moving with the characters. But then halfway through it gets into a brawl, and when the characters start running, and that is the difficult part. It is like you have to follow the character, and the characters should not go out of the frame, and you are moving through massive crowds who are not at all controllable. You don't have any control on the crowd. They'll just move in and out. There is just one instance where you can see the camera hit on someone's shoulder, and so what happens in the equipment is the camera is basically hung in the center of the equipment, and so once it is hit on a object, it'll take a while to balance itself to the center. The crowd was stretching from one point of the street to the other point of the street. So we had these loudspeakers which was hoisted in each post lamp, and so whichever instructions we give, so we knew that the crowd has the characters have moved from this house to that house, this place to this place. So we'll instruct it like that. So now you be attentive. The characters are moving to your place. Please don't look into the camera. The camera is coming behind. No, let please not hit on the camera. We have to cut the shot if you hit on the camera. Initially, we had planned a stunt artist who will come out of the fire and will fall in front of. So basically, both these guys will run into the fire, run to the close vicinity of fire. They'll have a fight. Marangoti Sijo, who's the negative guy, he's kicked into the fire. So after he being kicked into the fire, we literally go round the main guys and come behind the main guys so that we'll see the stunt artist coming from the fire outside. So that was a plan. So, but it didn't work like that because it looked so odd when the stunt artist did it. It wasn't looking real at all. So we had to remove the fire artist, and till the kick we shot and we revolved into the fireball. So which we later added a layer of fire and a structure passing through the fire later in the film. So finally, I remember when we finished the shot, DOP was literally, he just fell down, like, because he couldn't hold the cam, he couldn't literally stand up. When we were checking the shot, it was all we were breathing in and out, so heavy. Everyone, I still find a lot of flaws, but when I find it, this is what the best we could make it on that day. And I was so happy, and I said, great, I think we've got it. If you like this episode of Inside a Scene, please subscribe Film Companion for more videos.